to my channel. My name is Deepa and this is Divine Tarot by Deepa Sree. Yes, so without further ado, let's get into the video. And today I'm only going to use light seers. So let's see what's the energy that we have. Yes, so let me quickly give this a shuffle and shall we get started. So I'm only going to use light seers today. Yes, so where was I missing? Yes, let me quickly give this a shuffle. So I'm only going to use this tarot deck. Let's see what's the energy. So this is my second tarot deck that I purchased. Yes, so where was I? Yes, and what happened? Yes, so I want to talk about a concept today known as the noise cancellation mode. Yes, I'm gonna emphasize on this a lot. Yes, so yes, I'm gonna emphasize on this a lot. It is a concept which I discovered. Yes, and I really want to convey that on my channel. Yes, firstly, we crossed 150k, and actually I know it's a very unrealistic target, but I really want to hit 500k by the end of this year. So let's see if I can. Yes, so on that thought, what was I doing and where was I and all of that. Yes, so firstly, I am going to talk as we get into the video and, you know, as cards come out. Yes. So, yes. So, yeah, I'm really excited to come back to shooting and, you know, I was in a break zone. Yes. And I'm going to tell more about it. So, let's get into the video and let's see what's the first card. Yes. So, the first card, oh my God, did we start with the King of Pentacles? Yes. So, over the past, you know, so many years. Yes, so as a psychic, I am, you know, another psychic would understand. So we are really used to giving our energy, you know, to our clients, to people around us and all of that. Because, you know, God chose us to, you know, as an energy, you know, tank or whatever you want to call that. Yes, so we are used to giving our energy a lot to others. Yes, and I feel like for the first time in 30 years, yes, I feel like that this is the time that I have finally, you know, finally giving the energy to myself, to my inner self. Yes, King of Pentacles is somebody that has mastered all the kings. Yes, and I consider this the next card, like just a 5% difference from, you know, the Emperor. Yes, so I'm going to talk about, yes, the importance of, you know, noise cancellation mode, and all of these terminologies are very important because I think after I've achieved inner union and also a karmic victory, I believe that all I am doing is putting this energy after so many years into myself. And this is a concept that's very important in the journey of twin flames because it's a spiritual journey. And not only even twin flame journey, I believe that all of us have to attain this as we ascend in our soul, like your self soul. Yes, what is, you know, the concept of noise cancellation and how I think I am there? Yes, and I'll tell you what has happened, you know, over the time from when I've started this channel, met everybody, and, you know, a lot of this chatter patter, and I spoke about how I have cut out gossip in my past video. And let me tell you, there are a lot of things, you know, assumptions that I broke up with my soulmate, I'm mourning my twin flame and all of this. Nothing of that. All I did was, you know, cut out this noise. And I, you know, people sending me messages like, you know, I think you're crying, you know, and all of this. I believe that when you take a social media break and when you take break from all of this chaos, that is why, you know, people like sages and all of them just go and, you know, meditate and they find their inner peace and all of that. Trust me, that break. And let me tell you, people, and I am somebody that is always on social media. Yes. And I'm not too attached with it. If I have to leave all of this one day, I can do it. Yes. I'm not too attached. I do it for my work, but I'm not attached to it as well. And people on spiritual journey, you have to find your high priestess and you have to find your hermit mode. Yes. So when I was on this path of, you know, one day I randomly felt it from my heart that I just want to close my ears. You know, the three monkeys, one represents shutting down your ears, one represents shutting down your mouth, one represents shutting down my eyes. I felt like that. I don't want to discuss any bloody thing. And I feel that for, you know, the first time in my life, I feel like I'm the happiest in myself, in whatever I have, in whatever God has given me, blessed me, anything. And I think, and I feel like this is a part, like, for example, since I am a DF and I am finding this within me, and you know, your counterpart, your DM needs to find that within himself, because the two complete halves need to form the full half. And let me tell you, all these social norms like marriage, relationship, and all of these are again wants and desires that you are expecting from a twin flame. And remember that spiritual journey in ascension, it is you're together but not together. Basically, that's the concept. Yes. So mentally, you have to prepare yourself that, you know, for example, I always, like, everybody told me to watch Emily in Paris, and I have been, you know, completely, for some reason, I couldn't watch it always, yeah. And I am, you know, there is a saying that French, I know to speak so well French, yes. And there is a saying that, you know, there is not always a happy ending, yes, in French movies. And I believe that, you know, the happy ending which you're expecting, like you want a marriage, you want a family life, you want a kid, all of this with your twin flame, it should happen by fluke, like when you least expect it. Yeah, because a want and a desire is attached to it, because King of Pentacles represent a commitment. You are expecting something. And I feel that in this journey, your every want, your every desire will die down. And let me tell you, I am trying to put this in the most simplest words as I can, because I don't want to come here, make this serious content. I want to make sense, but in on a very happy life note. Yes. So I, you know, somehow detach myself from this. I would say from the last February last year, I have detached myself from this, you know, and I'm like, when I make the, you know, the wants, inner union, the wants video, you'll understand what it exactly means. Yes. You step out and pursue your life to the fullest. Yes. And let me tell you, there are many things which I wanted to do with my twin flame and always kept holding back, you know, but I pulled myself out of it. Yes. So I'm going to do it. And I believe that two full halves make the complete, like, you know, the complete circle, the full. This has to be 50-50, and, you know, however you want to put it. If there is a little bit deficient, yes, it's not going to complete. That's why the divine timing is too long and all of that. Yes. So I believe that I don't want to discuss. I'm not open to discussing. I don't want to talk to anybody. I don't want to do anything. And I feel like I, for the first time in my life, am fully putting the full energy, like in full mode, like the high priestess card, yes, into myself. So it's very important you reach this phase of this full inner commitment to yourself. Yes. So I believe that when a person is taking break, I always believe that you have to give this person this break. And it's okay to check on them and all of that. But this, I am in a phase because I have to make content. And it's very important to find the right energy and to know that what the fuck I have to speak. Yes. So I'm in this phase that I have sat in a shell. Like, you know, I've completely surrounded myself by the energy that I have been giving people from so many years. And if you're a DF and a psychic, you'll understand. So I have completely, for the first time in my life, that took all energy to myself. And I think this is the first time that I'm doing this, because always I was giving energy to my family, to my friends, to my clients, even to my twin flame. Yes, I pulled back. I think that if he's my counterpart, you know, he can definitely do on his own, and I think he can do it on his own. Yes. So this realization or this understanding need to come. Yes. And this is known as a noise cancellation mode, which I want to term it. Yes. It is this, I just want to shut out. You know, I don't want to know, I don't want to criticize, you know, I don't want to make fun of the karmic, you know, she wore this, she's this, she's this. No, this is not the qualities of, you know, somebody who's on a spiritual journey. You shouldn't be putting other people down. Yes, that's a basic common sense. And I don't want to do it. I don't want to discuss. I don't want to talk. I don't want to do anything. And for the first time in my life, I feel like I'm putting the entire energy into myself. Oh my God, where is the card? Yeah. So into myself, into my inner self, a King of Pentacles. It's not even a queen, it's a King of Pentacles, completely in yourself. Yes. Let's see what's the next card. Ace of Pentacles. And it is, and I feel, let me tell you, if somebody has taken a break, it doesn't mean that person is sitting and crying. Yes, it means that you have achieved so much peace within yourself. And I feel like, see, I feel like I am doing this year. And I feel like Mr. V attained this from last year itself. I really feel that, yes. So it is so peaceful, and you know, I think for the first time in my life, I think I'm putting the energy into myself. And I want to tell this that it's okay. Yes, just if you're really caring for me, if you're really worried about me, just send me a, you know, prayer. I will remember you and I'll think, okay, she's thinking about me. So and so person is thinking about me. I believe that a break, and especially from this noise, from this chatter patter, I just want a break. Yeah. And I'll tell you why this is happening. Because I'm a Rohini Nakshatra, I understand. So if you know the story of Moon and Rohini, yes. So Moon and Rohini are twin flames, yes. And Moon has always openly declared his love for, you know, Rohini. Yes, all he wanted to marry was her. But for the sake of astrology to come into place, all the other 26 daughters of Daksha Prajapati, yes, their father, the first daughter is Sati. So after, from second daughter, that is Ashwini, to all the way till Revati, like from the second daughter to the 28th daughter, means 27, apart from Sati, yeah. So all wanted to marry, you know, Moon. And Moon only wanted to marry Rohini, and he did tell that I only want to marry this. But you know, for the sake of astrology to come into place, that's how all the 27 nakshatras came into place. He married, you know, Rohini. Yeah, Rohini and the others, yes. And Rohini is his fourth wife, yes. So, you know, there is another big story. I need to make individually this story, but Rohini is a nakshatra where Moon gets exalted. Yes, and it comes here monthly once, like once in 27 days. Yeah, so when he's there, he's like fully complete because she is his, you know, complete other part of the soul. Yeah, she's his twin flame. Yeah, so now, yes, and I always, you know, made a video that Jupiter the husband and Venus the wife. So Jupiter right now is in the nakshatram of Rohini, and this happens once in 12 years. Yeah. And you're talking all about commitment. And I don't want to term the commitment, you know, to a person. Commitment here is to yourself. And I believe that no matter what is the outcome right now, I know that me and Mr. V have a connect, a wire, which is joining us. And I want to break the ice of all these social norms and all these pressure that people have from me that, you know, I have to be like this, I have to do this, we both have to be together and all of that. I just want to break the ice. I leave it to God and destiny. That is the free will, where it takes me. And am I happy right now? Yes, I'm happy and content in myself. It did take me a lot of time to come here. So on, if you have reached this video, let me tell you, it's not at all an easy journey. I struggled a lot, cried a lot and all of that. But am I crying now? Am I, like, from the past 15-20 days that I've disappeared? No. When I'm crying, I'm just open about it, yes. But now, right now, no. Because I believe that it's pointless no more of, you know, to cry and to, you know, to bust out and open and, you know, shout and all of that. I am just happy in my own space. And it's very important to cut out the noise cancellation because it's bullshit, yes. Nothing we're going to achieve by discussing all of this. I don't want to sit, gossip, you know, waste my energy in this. For the first time in my life, I feel like all the energy is to myself. I'm very particular about, I'm not answering much client calls, only which are emergency, I attend and all of that. Yes, for the first time in my life, I feel like I deserve this break and yes, I need it. So UDF will reach this phase. My eyes are non-stop catching this. High Priestess, you know, the cover of this Lights Years. After Raidavide, I think Lights Years is one of the best decks to buy, yes. So I believe that noise cancellation is very important in this journey, yes. So wherein you just cut out people, you know. I feel like now people are really understanding, and let me tell you what I have observed, and I know that for a fact, yes. I believe that when I have cut out, is everybody realizing of how much energy I was giving them. I was in it, even if all of these people spoke shit about me, backbited me and all of that. But now is when they will realize is how much energy I have really out of, you know, really given. And when there is a pull out, yes, is when you feel like, you know, for example, there is continue waterfall, yes, and when there is no water, one day it like, you know, God shut down this waterfall, is when you realize, oh my God, where is the water, yes. So I'm here talking about emotion and energy. So how much I was giving, I feel like now people are going to realize of how much I've given. We like, you know, I feel like V was always telling me this over the years, but I was just waiting to do it myself. Yes. So why I'm emphasizing on the nakshatra Rohini, I'll tell you, when Rohini was receiving this unconditional love from Moon, her husband, the other 26, her sisters and wives of Moon were very, very envious and jealous. Yeah. Because Moon made it very clear that he loves her the most. Yeah, for many years he never went to his other 27 wives. Yes, he was always with Rohini. Obviously because of the twin flame connect. Yes. So, you know, Rohini, at one point she was always telling her husband, why don't you, you know, other my sisters. She was always thinking about her sisters as well, that, you know, you should go to my other sisters. They are your wives and all of that. But after a point, she just cut out everybody. Let me tell you, because when her husband Moon felt really, really sick, because he had a curse on him that he will turn black. That is how the Amavasya came, yes. Only person that stood by him was Rohini, yes. That is why Lord Krishna chose this nakshatram very, very, very dearly, yeah. Lord, you know, there is a saying that there are 24 avatars of Lord Vishnu, yes. And I always tell that that is where I have to go, my Vaikuntham, yes. So the 27 nakshatras in that 26 left him when he was really sick. Yes, the only person that stood by him was Moon. So when you think of this Jupiter in Rohini, you know, it's coming once in 12 years and one of the biggest transits, yes, in astrology, because I have my Mars and Moon in both in Rohini, yes, and Jupiter is going on top of it, yes. So Moon gets exalted here. Exaltation is like 100 out of 100, yes. Full power to the planet, yes. So when it comes in the, you know, in the Vrishabh Rasi, in the nakshatram of Rohini especially, yes. And because we have Jupiter there all the way till August 20, and after this it's going to come back in the month of November again, yes. So all the way till February. This thing, so have you noticed Lord Krishna's avatar, wherein, you know, he completely is enjoying life to himself. He just, you know, such a tough war like Mahabharata, he just lightened it up, yeah. So it's all about that. Rohini is all about that. It's like a space. I feel like when Lord Vishnu suffered so much in the avatar of Ram, Krishna was like his, you know, redemption to, you know, enjoy, yeah. So that is exactly Jupiter in Rohini, wherein you are in the space of enjoying to yourself and not attached to any, I don't care a fuck what people are discussing and thinking, yeah. So I understand that, you know, it's okay, let them think what the fuck they want. And anyway, let me tell you, every Scorpion is blessed by it, yeah. So this noise cancellation, I feel like now people are gonna realize of how much energy I was actually giving them, yes. And it's okay, I did that as my duty, and now it's a time to say a bye and put all of this energy in myself. So that is exactly Jupiter in Rohini, which I'm trying to tell, is this, putting all of the energy here in your soul, in that fire, yeah. So that is exactly this commitment to yourself, yes. And the next card we have is, oh my God, can I make it up, Nine of Pentacles, to yourself, yes. So I am a full, like in my soul of 50%, I am the full shining bright half, yeah. So I'm sure he will also do his job, like your twin will do, you know, his job. And we have to wait, and time here is very specific to Saturn. I think as you reach this phase, even the time you let go, yes. So I believe that I am really in the zone of really enjoying my relationship with my soulmate. And I am openly telling that I don't want people to, you know, make assumptions. Oh my God, she's dating her soulmate, you know, she's making video on twin flame and all of that. It's okay, yeah. And one thing that I've really understood, that instead of discussing this chatter patter with all this just twin flame gang, it's so nice to sit in your peace. And if you really want to know what is happening that side of, you know, of your twin flame and all of that, just go and watch a YouTube video. It's so easy, just keep it to yourself. Nine of Pentacles talks about that. Just you know, enjoy this silence. I feel like I finally am mastering it. I am loving it. Yes. So I have been binge watching Emily in Paris. Oh my God, I have a huge crush on Gabrielle. Yes. And yeah, the hot French chef. He's the protagonist of the show. Yes. So I am really loving, you know, watching this. I'm in the season 2. Yes. So because I understand and speak French very well, for me it's so more fun loving to watch. And I have been loving, I was watching Bridgerton. Oh my God, it's so good. I love Bridgerton because it's like my past life. You know, I've lived like that. I have lived in London, you know, having that royal life and all of that. Yes, so I connect to that show a lot. Yes, so I believe that you have to go there, out there. And when I make the inner union, the wands. Yes, many people like the swords, but I am waiting for that calling to make the wands. And I'm still preparing the content, I believe. Yes, so I'll do it shortly. Yes. Yes, so I am really excited to shoot that. So stay tuned. Yes. So all of this is very important because Jupiter in Rohini is here to tell you that you are worth. Yes. And like after Lord Vishnu suffered so much in the avatar of Lord, you know, Ram, he had Lord Krishna wherein he was, you know, he was teaching the world to have fun with yourself. Yes. So, you know, it is all about this. And Jupiter in Rohini is here to tell you that, you know, go explore life. Yes. And I, Eight of Pentacles, all Pentacles only wanna come. Yeah. So go explore life. Go pursue. Do everything. And I have a lot of secrets, but I am holding them. Yes. So, yeah. I think, you know, when the time comes, actions speak louder than the words. And that is how it is. Yes. So, yeah. Oh my God, now finally the Queen of Pentacles came. I feel like I'm in this energy wherein I have really understood the true worth of myself. So this is where I inspire you to, you know, this is gonna take some time. I'm not telling that I was not doing gossip or I was not, you know, discussing or that I was not, you know, I think I took my time. Yes, and now I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to discuss about it. I found so much peace in myself. So that is the exactly Jupiter in Rohini. Yes, God will teach you, universe will teach you, yeah, how to attain this yourself. It can be, you know, now or it can be in November. Yeah, but you will see a lot of DF reach this. Yes, and let me tell you the months in Parvati. Yes, and let me tell you, you have to undergo all of that. You have to achieve a sexual union. You have to achieve an inner union. You have to achieve a karmic victory. It's so much work. It shows that how much work, like it's like a game, right? You have to level up. You have to, as the levels are, you know, increasing, it gets harder. Game gets harder. It's like that. And I have really in this journey, really understood the true meaning of this journey, because making these videos, I have really found myself. Yes. So if somebody is taking a break, it doesn't mean they're not fine. Or then just wait for them to come back and tell you. It's very good to check on people. But in this journey, a break is very, 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 very important. Yes. Cut out the chatter-patter for your own happiness. The Ten of Pentacles. Yes. So yes. So Jupiter in Rohini is all about this self, you know, focus. Yes. So, yeah. It's all about this self-focus is, you know, find your own happiness. I feel like God wants you to stop depending on your twin flame for every fucking single happiness. You have every right to fulfill your own desires. And I tell that for even this guy. Just go out, live your life. Yes. So we have to do that with self, you know, openness. And I think some of the DF need to stop sulking. Like, you know, he is very happy in his life and all of that. It's like, why? Why are you sulking? I feel like they're sulking and they don't want, you know, your twin. Why? I feel like, you know, you should let go of this thought and let them live their self. Yes. So in today's video, I'm really here to speak about this. Because I'm going through this. And I think that's an energy because Jupiter is in Rohini. Yes. And we have all the planets right now in Gemini, which talks about a lot of air, like a lot of talk. Yeah. Talk to yourself. Yes, and that's the best phase in this journey. We understand the power of telepathy. We understand the power of talking to yourself, listening to your voice, connecting to your inner, you know, your third eye, connecting to yourself. That is your inner union. Yes, lot of things. Yes, and if you ask me, will I do this journey again? No. The straight cut answer is that, because I feel like I just want to leave things behind. Yeah, so I'm leaving all of it behind. Yes, so especially when I made the 2024, the black video. Yes, from there is when I connect to my channel. From there is when I know that there is a lot of growth in my channel. Yes, so all of that past, I don't even, let me tell you, I forgot all of the half content that I made on this channel. Like, I'm leaving everything in the past. Yes, so I am proud that I've reached so far. Like this, every DF, I request you to leave your past behind. Every decision, I think you should stop being hard on yourself. Yes. So this video, if it's, you know, reaching somebody, it's not about energy. It is about a state. I feel like a state in your journey. Yes. And this journey, for the first time, I know I always said that I'm making these videos for to teach my twin flame. And then there was a shift. After my twin flame really understood, all this journey and all of that, then there was a shift to connect to all my DF. For the first time in my life, now I know why I made this channel, is because I'm my dad's daughter. Yes? So, because my dad always, you know, was very good in astrology and all of that, this channel is a dedication to my father. Yes, now that is my purpose. So, I am here teaching about a noise cancellation concept. It's very important you do this in your journey, that just love to yourself. Like, I mean, I'm watching these shows and I'm enjoying myself, company so much. I'm not telling just cut out your friends, live in a room and all of that. Yes. It's this peace, inner peace. And I think I'm conveying that to you. Now all of the energy is to myself. I just taking my all energy to myself for the first time in my life. Yes. So let's see what's the next energy. Oh my God. We have the card of devil, so definitely your twin is really missing you and wants your energy and all of that. He's really, always whenever you get a devil, it's, you know, more of like he's masturbating and all of that. But I really feel like he's missing your energy, your touch, your words and your presence and all of that. I'm getting that energy a lot. So I'm willing to stop. This was a very informative video. So yeah, so this space is, you know, finally I feel like, because Jupiter is in Rohini, I want you to connect to yourself, your own, you know, solar plexus chakra, like your, what do you want to do? Yes. Yeah. Yes. So that's it. Energy that I want to convey. I hope you enjoyed and learned something, a point or two. So I will see you in the next video wherein I really convey energy. Yes, my lovelies, I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, Andarki namaskaram. I really want my South Indian crowd on my channel. Yes. So I'm, you know, really manifesting that. Yes. So on that thought, I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, this is Deepa bidding a bye. Bye, guys.